Another useful tool is the Break at Point tool. With this tool, we can split a line or a curve into two different objects. The Break at Point tool can be found if we expand the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Once the tool is active, a message prompts me to select the object I wish to break. In the first example, I am going to select the spline. Then, I need to specify where the spline will break, so I will click on the point that has been placed on the spline. I should mention that in order to select the point, I need the node snap active. The command deactivates automatically, and notice that there are now two splines that were once part of the same spline. At this point, I will move on to show you another example of how this command can be used. As you can see, this is the top view of a staircase. Usually, in the floor plans, the part of the stair which is below the section of the floor we are drawing is represented by continuous lines indicating that it is visible in the floor plan. On the other hand, the part of the stair that is above the section and is not visible in the floor plan is drawn with dashed lines. Those two parts of the stair are distinguished by a diagonal, and as you can see, each step is indicated by a straight line. Back to the example, let's say I want to change the continuous lines that represent the part of the stair that is not visible in this floor plan into dashed lines. Instead of drawing two different lines for each step that is crossed by the diagonal, I can just split the existing ones into two lines. For this reason, I will activate the Break at Point command. Since the point I want them to split is where the straight lines intersect with the diagonal, I will open the snaps list and activate the intersection snap. In this way, the cursor will be pulled towards the intersection of the lines. I will close the snaps list and select the first line I want to split. Then, I will move my cursor near the intersection, and once the X symbol of the intersection snap appears, I will click on it. The command deactivates automatically, and notice that the line I selected is split into two lines. I will repeat the same procedure for the last step of the stair that is crossed by the diagonal. I will activate the Break at Point tool again and select the second line. Next, I will click on the intersection point, and as you can see, once again, the line has split into two lines. Finally, I am going to select all the lines that I want to be dashed and change their type from continuous to hidden. We are going to learn how to change the line type in more detail in the following lessons. So, to sum up, in some cases, splitting lines and curves in a certain point is way easier and quicker than drawing each part individually over again.